you hold them off?
There's too many. I don't think we can survive until you get here. I'm activating the bomb.
What?
What the hell are you doing, Alenko?
I'm just making sure this bomb goes off, no matter what. It's done, Commander. Go get Williams and get the hell out of here.
I didn't give that order.
Screw that. We can handle ourselves. Go back and get Alenko.
Rescue him from what? Himself? He's just making up his own damn mind. I'm the commander here. Rescue Ashley. And while we're at it, all the Salarians with her,
Williams,
hopefully.
Radio Joker and tell him to meet us on the AA tower.
Yes, Commander,
It's the right choice, and you know it, Ash.
Wait, is he blowing himself up with the bomb? Just hold on. I don't know.
Stay alive. I'll be coming to get you too, Caden.
I think we both know that's not gonna happen, Commander.
What? What? You ass, I did not give you permission for this.
The Salarians are counting on us, Shepard. We can't let them down.
I know. Oh, Jesus, guy. What happens when people just do things without conferring with the commander?
You need to move fast, Commander. Can't hold them off here much
longer. I'm trying to move very fast at this point. Come on. Ooh, bada boom. Oh, who's this? Ooh. Oh my, we've got a... Saren, I presume. And the music is very loud at this point. Well, here's...
This has been an impressive diversion, Shepard. My Geth were utterly convinced the Salarians were the real threat. Of course, it was all for nothing. I can't let you disrupt what I've accomplished here.
Well, of course not.
You can't possibly understand what's really at stake.
Yeah, oh, it's a mistake or at stake, which is a mistake. You work for a Reaper.
Sovereign and its kind destroyed the Protheans. What else is there to understand?
You've seen the vision from the beacon, Shepard. You of all people should understand what the Reapers are capable of. They cannot be stopped. Do not mire yourself in pointless revolt. Do not sacrifice everything for the sake of petty freedoms. The Protheans tried to fight, and they were utterly destroyed.
You think they won't kill you too?
Dead. But what if they had bowed before the invaders? Would the Protheans still exist? A submission not preferable to extinction.
So you're basically a coward, and you're willing to become a slave. You're fooling yourself if you think they don't care anything about you.
Do you really believe the Reapers will let us live?
Now you see why I never came forward with this to the Council. We organics are driven by emotion instead of logic. We will fight even when we know we cannot win. But if we work with the Reapers, if we make ourselves useful, think how many lives could be spared. Once I understood this, I joined Sovereign, though I was aware of the dangers. I had hoped this facility could protect me.
Huh. Yeah, well, you're just a puppet. They're controlling you, too. If not, they will be shortly. How can you, a mere organic, even be capable of understanding what they want. How do you know what could be useful to them? If anything. You're just a puppet.
You're like every other poor bastard in this place. A tool Sovereign can use, then cast aside.
I've studied the effects of indoctrination. The more control Sovereign exerts, the less capable the subject becomes. That is my saving grace. Sovereign needs me to find the conduit. My mind is still my own. For now.
Yeah, for now.
The transformation from ally to servant can be subtle. I will not let it happen to me.
Yeah, about this conduit.
Tell me why Sovereign needs the conduit. Tell me what it is. Maybe we can find a way to stop them.
The conduit is the key to your destruction and my salvation. Sovereign needs my help to find it. That is the only reason I have not been indoctrinated.
And how do the Geth figure into all this?
Why are the Geth following Sovereign?
They believe Sovereign to be some kind of god, the pinnacle of their own evolution. But the reaction of their deity is most telling. It is insulted. Sovereign does not desire the pitiful devotions the Geth hurl at it. They are just tools, and no amount of belief on their part will change that. But as tools, they are useful. They will survive the coming invasion. If organic life is to survive, we must also prove we are useful. We must work with the Reapers.
You're a coward, Saren.
I'm not like you. I'd rather die fighting than live as a slave.
I'm not doing this for myself. Don't you see? Sovereign will succeed. It is inevitable. My way is the only way any of us will survive. I'm forging an alliance between us and the Reapers, between organics and machines. And in doing so, I will save more lives than have ever existed. But you would undo my work. You would doom our entire civilization to complete annihilation. And for that, you must die.
Oh, you gotta turn me all around. My boss battle. I blow the tank. He's coming. Get away from the bomb! We're leaving him? We're on the ship now?
Alright everybody, hang on!
Oh shit!
I can't believe Caden didn't make it. How could we just leave him down there?
And here I thought I was throwing Ashley to the wolves. He was a good soldier.
Alenko knew the risks going in. He gave his life to save the rest of us.
It should have been me, Commander. You know that.
Don't blame yourself, Ashley.
It wasn't your call, Williams. I had to choose. I chose you.
I'm sorry, Commander. You saved my life. I'm grateful for that. But it should have been me. Alenko was a superior officer. I would have gladly stayed behind.
Don't sacrifice yourself.
Ash, how far are you going to drive yourself? Are you trying to be a martyr? To redeem your grandfather's honor?
That's not fair.
We need you.
What the public and the military did to him was unfair, but I don't want to lose a good soldier over it.
Aye, Commander.
Commander, excuse me for interrupting, but I have an idea. I think the beacon you found in Saren's base was similar to the one you found on Eden Prime. It may have filled in the missing pieces of your vision. I might be able to help you put all those pieces together.
I was actually looking forward to that. Yeah, do it.
You want to join our minds again, don't you? Okay, go ahead.
Relax, aww. Commander.
She's so pretty.
Embrace eternity.
I just find it so inspiring when you say that. Yeah, that's the thing that hungers for flesh and stuff, and the wires hooked into flesh, organic matter, machines put together. There's that two suns, and there's a planet, or there's a moon with a planet in front of it. Inside is one of those.
I never thought the images would be so intense. I need a moment to collect myself.
Hurry up. What did you see?
Did the vision make any sense to you?
It's a distress call. A message sent out across the Prothean Empire. A warning against the Reapers, but the warning came too late.
Anything else?
What about the conduit?
There were other images. Locations. Places I recognize from my research. Ilos! The conduit is on Ilos! That is why Saren needed to find the new relay. It is the only way to get to Ilos.
Huh. You never mentioned this.
How come you never told us about Ilos before?
The new relay links to dozens of systems and hundreds of worlds. How was I to know Ilos was the one we wanted?
Okay.
Without the cipher, the images in your visions were never clear. Only now do I recognize them as landmarks from Ilos.
Alright, let's go.
We need to get to Ilos.
Forget it. The Mew relay's inside the Terminus systems. Alliance ships are not welcome there. Neither are Spectres.
Yeah, well, we have no choice.
The conduit's on Ilos. That's where Saren's heading. I'll be waiting for him when he gets there.
Saren will have his entire fleet orbiting Ilos. You will never make it down to the surface without reinforcements. You must alert the Council. We need a fleet to... I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
Yeah, well, I have that kind of effect on people. You okay?
Dr. Chalkwash should take a look at you.
That will not be necessary. I just need some rest. Somewhere quiet.
Okay. Go ahead.
We're done here. Dismissed.
Commander, there's a comm buoy nearby. I can link us in if you want to report back to the Citadel Council. You know, to warn him about Sovereign.
Tempted to say why bother. They're probably not going to believe half of what I say, but fine, do it.
Set the link up, Joker. They need to know.
Patching it through.
Commander Shepard, I'm pleased to see your mission on Vermeer was a success.
Oh, was it?
Saren is formidable enough without an army of Krogan serving under him.
Yeah, well, Saren's not exactly the one in charge.
The Krogan would have served Sovereign, a Reaper.
Yes, we saw mention of this on your report. Sovereign, Ascension Machine, a true artificial intelligence. This news is quite alarming, if it turns out to be accurate.
It is accurate.
Sovereign's a Reaper. Saren admitted it.
He's playing you, Shepard. Saren still has contacts on the Citadel. He probably saw your earlier reports. The ones talking about your vision and the Reapers.
Yo, I talked to this thing.
It's highly possible Saren is using false information to throw you off balance. Our own intelligence has never turned up any corroborating information.
You need proof, huh?
Sooner or later, you're gonna have to take something I say on faith, Counselor.
Try to see this from our perspective, Commander. Saren is a threat we can recognize. However, as far as we know, the Reapers only exist in your visions.
Our decisions affect trillions of lives. We cannot act on the accusations of a single person, even a Spectre. Not without solid evidence.
The Council cannot take any official action here. That is why we created the Spectres. You have the authority to act as you see fit.
If you truly believe Sovereign is the real threat, you must take whatever steps are necessary to stop it. And Saren.
Good luck, Commander. From all of us.
You know, I wasn't expecting you to actually do anything. I was just giving you my report. I knew you wouldn't do crap. I'm the one who does everything around here. let's go around and talk to the crew.
Yes, Commander?
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
I wonder if he ever has anything new to say. No, I thought that was... I always check on Joker, just in case.
Commander, I know it couldn't have been easy for you down there. Making the call between Alenko and Williams must have been... I'm sorry, ma'am. I just don't know if I could have done it.
Yeah. Pray you never have to make a decision like that, Joker.
And there is no right choice for something like that. I just hope I never have to go through it again.
No, I'm not blaming you, Commander. I'm just... I mean, it's hard, you know?
Now, mind you guys, I was never, that fond of Caden. I mean, he was okay, but still, I recognize this as a heavy loss. So I'm going to treat it as such. Any member of my crew, we don't want to lose. Are you alright?
Saren's still out there, Joker. Hold it together. We need you.
Don't worry, I won't let you down. I want to be there when you make that son of a bitch pay.
I'd love to see that happen.
I'll be okay, Commander. Just need some time.
Time right now is something we actually do have. I love this theme playing here. Me in, damn it. Whoop. I can't go talk to Caden. That's sad. Bed looks very small. Kind of wondering if you have any codex entry. We have to, right? Council races. Okay, some stuff about Salarians here. Government? The Salarian government is called the Salarian Union. It is a labyrinthine web of matrilineal bloodlines with political alliances formed through interbreeding. In many ways, the Salarian political network functions like the noble families of Earth's medieval Europe. Structurally, the government consists of fiefdoms, baronies, duchies, I think, planets, and marches, colonization clusters. There are human nicknames. These are human nicknames. The original Salarian is unpronounceable. Each area is ruled by a single Dalatras, matriarchal head of household, and represents an increasing amount of territory and prestige within the Salarian political web. approaching 100 members, the first circle of a Salarian's clan comprises parents, siblings, uncles, aunts, and cousins. The next circle includes second cousins, etc., and escalates to well over 1,000 members. The fourth or fifth circle of a clan numbers into the millions. Salarian loyalty is greatest to their first circle and diminishes from there. Their photographic memories allow Salarians to recognize all their myriad relatives. And military doctrine. In principle, the Salarian military is similar to the Alliance, a small volunteer army that focuses on maneuver warfare. What differentiates the Salarians is not their equipment or doctrine, but their intelligence services and rules of engagement. The Salarians believe that a war should be won before it begins. Conventional wisdom holds that the Salarians know everything about everyone, and this is not far from the truth. In war, the unquestioned superiority of their intelligence services allows them to use their small military to maximum effectiveness. Well before fighting breaks out, they possess complete knowledge of their enemy's positions, intentions, and timetable. In every war the Salarians have fought, they struck first and without warning. For the Salarians, to know an enemy plans to attack and let it happen is folly. To announce their own plans to attack is insanity. They find the human moral concepts of do not fire until fired upon and declare a war before prosecuting it incredibly naive. In defensive wars, they execute devastating preemptive strikes hours before the enemy's own attacks. On the offense, they have never telegraphed their intentions with a declaration of war before attacking. Biotics are virtually unknown in the Salarian military. Those with such abilities are considered too valuable to be used as cannon fodder and are assigned to the intelligence services. While capable of defending themselves against most threats, the Salarians know that they are small fish in a universe filled with sharks. As a point of survival, they have cultivated strong alliances with larger powers, particularly with the Turians. Though the relationship between the two species was rocky at first due to the Krogan uplift fiasco, the Salarians take pains to keep this relationship strong enough that anyone who might threaten them risks Turian intervention. Those little tidbits. Right.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
How did you end up serving on an Alliance ship?
I enlisted right out of med school. Earth always seemed boring to me. I wanted to travel, but humanity needs the Alliance if we want to keep expanding through the Traverse. And the Alliance...
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Just cut her right off. Thought she might have something new to say. Liara...
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
Yes, actually. I was worried.
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
We've been through this conversation before. She's the best.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I've been thinking about Saren. I actually feel a little sorry for him now.
Hmm. Why?
He's the last person I'd feel sorry for.
He's trapped inside his own mind. Part of him senses his identity slowly being swallowed up by Sovereign, but he is powerless to stop it. I wonder how he first fell into Sovereign's trap. Did he think he could somehow stop the Reapers from returning? Or was he simply driven by a lust for power and glory?
We might never know.
Whatever Saren's reasons may have been, they're long gone now. He has to be stopped.
Yes, I suppose you're right. He may be Sovereign's victim, but he is also a threat to all life as we know it. Let's not spend every free minute talking about Saren. It is bad enough we are chasing him across the galaxy.
True. There's nothing else to say.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Short but sweet. head down to talk to the rest of our crew. Oh, good, we did pick up some of these guys.
You have my gratitude, Commander. Most people would have left our team behind. Still, I find the loss of Captain Kirahi troubling. But I won't blame you. I know you lost one of your own as well.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Captain Kirahi will be missed. But many others will live because he gave his life.
That is our lot, I suppose. But there may come a day when so many have been sacrificed, it will be impossible to tell who won. The mission was a success. That will have to be enough. We won't trouble you for long. Our unit will be disbanded as soon as we depart. Good luck, Commander Shepard.
Good luck to you. Kinda wish we could talk to the rest of these guys with just a single line. Rex.
Commander. Things got heated back on Vermeier. You did what you had to do. I respect your choice.
Thank you.
I appreciate what you did, Rex. I won't forget it.
Just make sure it was worth it. Saren has to pay for what he's done.
Oh, he will.
No matter what it takes, I'm gonna hunt him down and kill him.
I like the sound of that.
I figure you would.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Commander?
About Caden.
About Lieutenant Alenko. How are you holding up?
Can't say I'm better. Sorry for anything I said back there. I don't want any deaths on my hands, and it's my fault.
It's not your fault.
Williams, listen to me. I'm in command of this mission. I made the call, not you. He's dead because of me.
Wow.
It's funny. I don't have any fear of dying for the Alliance. But when I think of someone dying for me, if you don't mind my asking, how did you deal with the losses in Elysium?
I grieved. Later.
I didn't stop and agonize over it while everyone else was in danger. We've got work to do, Williams. We'll remember him later.
Yeah. A good guy like him must be with God now, huh? So, nothing to be sad about. He must be happier. Thanks for the advice, Skipper.
Skipper. That's gotta be a lot to try to take that off Ashley's conscience by just coming out and telling him he died because of me.
What's your opinion of the last mission?
We've got a hard fight ahead.
Heh.
Fleets of AI dreadnoughts who've exterminated all life dozens of times over? I think the odds are against us.
Screw the odds.
When it comes to the survival of humanity, who gives a rat's ass about odds? We're gonna fight them.
Damn straight we will, Skipper. But I'm infantry. Against Reapers, my rifle may as well fire spitballs. I won't have a place in this war. That's what pisses me off, not being able to shoot back.
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
I should get back to my duty, Skipper. Rifles don't maintain themselves. Not yet, anyway.
Okay, then.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.
She usually rejects that question, interestingly enough. Garrus.
Commander, I wanted to thank you.
We've been through this.
What for, Garrus?
For everything. Taking me with you, letting me be part of your team. Thanks, Commander.
You bet.
You're welcome, Garrus.
I do want to sell things, but not on screen.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Hey, Shepard. You need something?
I should go.
See you later.
I'm surprised Tally doesn't have anything to say. Everyone else has something to say except for her. Oh, it's funny the way his suit's lit up like that. I thought he was one of those Geth slaves. Like, what? You're not welcome on our crew. Oh, so now we just got this race against time thing. Report to the council. I just did that. Right? Yeah, I did that. Going to the map then?
I forwarded the mission update to the Citadel, Commander. We got confirmation on those reinforcements. Ambassador Udino wants us to report back to the Citadel. The Council's massing a joint species fleet to deal with Saren and his Geth.
Well, it's about time.
Took them long enough. Back to the Citadel, Joker. I want the Normandy at the head of that fleet.
Yes, ma'am.